to it. We've got Jerrod Appenzeller and Josh Hamilton on the break point on the left. Jerrod on the right. A little bit of a size difference here, you can see. Both choosing to stand and wrestle. I'm honestly curious myself to see how people are going to go through this rule set. Nice little snap down to the front headlock, get out of it pretty easy. And you can see on the right side sitting down, his hands on his knees. Kieran Kachuk is going to be in this division a little bit later today. He won the absolute division last time. Tough guy, with some great jiu-jitsu, a black belt out of TLI. Still standing up. Obviously the points are going to affect this guy, you know, until halfway through the match. We're not going to see any points here, so probably a little bit of messing around on the feet until they get a little bit comfortable, or being the smaller guy, I assume he doesn't want to pull the wrong way. He probably wants something comfortable. So. Post-COVID, it's good to see. We're about 150, 200 people in this like nice little basketball room we got. The old Franklin High School. Four minutes on the clock. I know you guys can't see it, but we've got 4 minutes, or one more minute down, and then we've got some points. So maybe after 60 seconds, we'll see these guys shoot for a takedown or try to get that 2 points. Seen any shots really, just some hand fighting or underhook by Jerrod. Snap single attempt. What about 15 seconds until we'll see some points here? Probably see a change in pace once that timer goes down, or maybe the referee will let them know so they know how to go. We've got points now, you can hear the coaches yelling from the background. 2 minutes and 50 seconds. Oh, that's a nice shot here. Referee wasn't paying attention on that one. I'm not sure if he's going to award the two and reset him in that position. It was a good shot by Jerrod. It's 2 points he should award. Curious what he's going to do with this knee shield from bottom here. Being the bigger guy, I'm not sure if he expected to land up on bottom, but... That's 2 points for Jerrod with the red band on his ankle. We've got 2 minutes on the clock left. With a knee shield from Josh on bottom. Looking for an underhook, maybe looking to wrestle up here. Let's see what he's going to do from here. I can imagine it's pretty tough trying to get your right leg out of a dude with big legs like that. Chin strap here, putting him back on his back. That's good control to stop the wrestle up. Might come through the back door and come up here in the deep half. I don't think that guillotine is threatening him. Maybe a Kimura trap here on the other side. We'll see. That's nice. It's a good transition there from Jerrod. He's probably going to get squashed a little bit here. Doesn't want to give up the points coming out of it. And that's 2 points. guys don't know the rule set here, even if it's coming out of a submission or from bottom to top side control, you're going to get awarded 2 points. You know, so if you're on bottom side control, you get your guard passed and you sweep the guy to side control, it's actually 5 points. So you've got 1 minute on the clock and it's 2-2. So if we see this time go down, it's golden score. First to score, there's actually no time limit on the golden score. So we see these guys bang it out. Orlando Sanders, table working. The most handsome man in jiu-jitsu, if you guys didn't know. We've got some good pressure here. Shoving his head through. I'm not sure really how he's going to pass here unless the guy really opens his legs up and gives it to him. 25 seconds here. Let's see if he does anything from close guard. We've got 15 seconds left. Oh, nice little Kimura trap here. Maybe he's going to get some points over there. This is cool. Oh, a little big for that, but you know, we'll see. Looking at the time, he's probably tired. I reckon he's going to try to get to overtime. No slams here in subspectrum, but I might have picked him up and gave him a little slammy boo right there. That would have been good. Now we got overtime, so guys are going to basically go until points are scored, and then the winner is going to be sided like that. So no time limit. These guys are big. I don't want them running to the table over here. I'm glad he's taking care of us. I'm curious what these guys' tactics are going to be. You know, if I was in overtime, I'd probably just send it because I don't know any better. But you know, maybe run the clock down a little bit, wait till your guy gets tired, and then shoot a takedown, or I don't know. I think he's saying that he keeps grabbing his pants. Not sure. Nice little slide by. Probably like to see another single leg chop from Jerrod. He got a nice one at the start of the match. It was out of bounds. I'm not sure if the other fellow just the match stop, but it was a nice two. Got a Russian tie here. Maybe he's going to pull it up, snap him down to a single leg. And shooting, nice reshot off that. Nice, Jerrod. Here we go. This could be it. They're running out of bounds. It's a snap down. Mahmoud's probably going to reset him in the same position in the middle. Knees are on that basketball court. I don't know. I know that doesn't feel good. And remember guys, no time limit here, so basically whoever scores first is going to win, and we'll see. He's coming from the front headlock here. I assume he's got to either circle to the back, put some heavy pressure on him. It was a nice shot, but he's got a Kimura trap. He's sitting to his back, and I think that's two. Yep. Time. It's 2 points, a good 2 points. He shot, fell to his back, that's 2 points by... We've got Josh Hamilton coming through the win, you know, that was a decent match, pretty much mostly wrestling and some half guard stuff. I think Jerrod had a chance with that Kimura trap in the corner, but Josh being the bigger guy, managed to squirm out of that one. So he's going to move on to the next round, and we'll see how he goes against these other fellas, you know.